Welcome back. I'm excited to help you learn full stack application development with Angular and Spring Boot. And I'm sure you are as excited as I am. In this step, let's discuss the high level architecture of the application we are going to build in this specific course. Let's start with understanding the basic functionality of the application that we are going to build. We are going to build a to-do management application. Everyone has things you would want to do, you would want to learn. You can manage them in this specific to-do management application. You can add to-dos, delete to-dos, update. Other than that, we'll also have authentication and authorization features, typically login and logout capabilities. Let's now shift our attention towards the high-level architecture of this application. What we are going to develop is a full-stack web application. Whenever we talk about a full-stack application, we are talking about a front-end application which is talking to a back-end API or a web service. In this course, we'll be using Angular to build the front-end application. Angular is one of the most popular frameworks to build front-ends. Angular has a variety of features like components, modules, forms, HTTP communication to talk with the web services. It makes it easy to develop front-end applications. Angular uses a language called TypeScript. If you're new to TypeScript, then TypeScript is nothing but modern JavaScript plus typing. We'll discuss a little bit more about TypeScript in a subsequent video. For now, it's sufficient to understand that the front-end application will be developed using the Angular framework, which would be based on a language called TypeScript. To build the RESTful API or the RESTful web services in the backend, we will be using the Spring Boot framework. We would be using Java as the language. Spring Boot is the number one Java framework to build RESTful APIs and microservices. We will create multiple RESTful services for authentication as well as to-do management. As far as authentication is concerned, we will start with basic authentication and also discuss about how to use JWTs or JSON Web Tokens for authentication. We will be using the Spring Security Framework to build authentication around the RESTful API. Before we move on to the next step, let's discuss an important question. We are talking about full stack application. Why should you really build a full stack application? Why should you create a separate backend and a separate front end? There is a lot of complexity associated with building separate backends and frontends. You need to understand multiple languages. You need to understand multiple frameworks like Spring Boot and Angular. Why should you do that? The most important reason is to create a flexible architecture which can be extended to meet the future needs. Let's imagine that you would want to develop a native mobile application in future. Let's say you would want to develop an iPhone app or you would want to develop an Android application. Maybe you would want to connect with an Internet of Things device. In such kind of situations, you can completely reuse the backend API that is being exposed. The full stack application with a separate backend API or the RESTful API and a frontend will give you more options to extend your architecture and create applications for different devices. In this quick video, we looked at the architecture of the application that we are going to create. We would create an Angular application talking to a RESTful API built on top of Spring Boot. We discussed why we build full stack applications. I'll see you in the next step. Until then, bye-bye.